In this lesson, I'm going to talk to you about how we rolled out Fin AI Copilot to our team at Intercom, and you are also going to hear from two of our customers who were on the beta. Before we dive in, here is an overview of all the steps that we took. So first, you're going to want to test it out yourself. This could be you as a manager or maybe some team leads. Two, you're going to want to enable your team. Three, really simple, turn it on for your team. And there's also another step here, which is to optimize your help content. Now, you can do this at any point, but of course, the earlier, the better. Now, this may seem like a lot of steps, so feel free to pick and choose based on, you know, your industry, your team size, and the amount of capacity you have to dedicate to this. But if you're comfortable with AI, feel free to switch it on straight away. It's not immediately customer facing, so it's not going to have a negative impact on your customer experience. So let's talk about step one. This should just be to test it out yourself or to have your team leads test it out and really just put Fin AI Copilot through its paces. Now, this can be something as simple as asking it the top 10 types of questions that your team gets on a daily basis. But for some more advice, here is Emil and Angelo, two of our beta customers.
If we were to implement Copilot again, one of the things that we would definitely do different maybe is spending a bit more time upfront to test it on the, let's say, the managerial side, to get a couple of great examples and also to see maybe some of the areas for improvement. So we can then use this as a point of reference whenever we started to train the team on adopting that feature.
You need to really try it yourself and not rely solely on your agents adopting it. So in our beta phase, I myself was one of the first people to really stretch the legs on it and see how it worked and what it could do. That way, when I spoke to my teams, we were able to come from a very informed place. And it wasn't guesswork, it wasn't hypothesis, it was showing, you know, true to form examples. And it also meant that I could test it in the cases that I expected it would be used and determine if, you know, the content it had been fed was sufficient and all of those sorts of things. So I believe my first bit of advice would be to really make sure that you try it yourself and really get a feel for how it's going to be used and run some true-to-life tests.
So I think the key takeaway here from Emil and Angelo is that you need to use Fin AI Copilot enough to get a sense of how it works with your content. And then take these learnings and use them to enable your own team. So let's chat a bit about how we did that at Intercom. So the first thing we did was pick 10 experienced agents, that's our Tiger team, and we ran an enablement session with them. And we went through all the things that worked, all the things that didn't, where we thought it could help them the most, and maybe where not to use it for. Next, we created a Slack channel for these agents and we asked them to test it out and share their experiences. So any success stories of when it worked really well, any examples of when it didn't, or any weirdness, and any content gaps or suggestions for content. Now, during this time, it probably went on for about a week or two. The team also sought anecdotal feedback in one-to-ones and daily stand-ups, and at the end, we used a survey like this to understand and review their experiences. Having this Slack channel as a forum was a really great way to generate buzz and encourage our team to try it out. And after a week, we had a really good sense of what worked and a list of areas for our content to be improved in. And we were also able to use all the content and examples generated from this Slack channel to onboard and enable the rest of our team. Here's Emil again on the importance of having your team involved in the process.
And as we rolled out Copilot at our company, one of the most important things that we focused on was communicating the value and explaining the impact of it for our frontline team members. So what I mean by that is that it was important for us to communicate the benefit and the value they can draw out of a smart assistant like Copilot is, so that they can spend more time talking with users, engaging with them, and working with them on helping them become successful in adopting the product, as opposed to spending way too much time just trying to find answers and trying to find relevant resources.
Rolling Fin AI Copilot to the rest of the team was really easy from here, as we already had all the content and context that we needed, and we even let them snoop on the Slack channel to create a sense of interest around Fin AI Copilot. And one thing that I do want to flag here though is around using Fin AI Copilot as a tenured experienced agent versus as a brand new agent. Now, experienced agents are usually super efficient, they already know the answers to most things or how to find the answer fast. So even among the Intercom support team, there was some skepticism around how it would be useful for them. But our tenured agents were still able to get a lot of value from Fin because our product moved so fast. Topics that they were once experts in have changed, and Fin was able to catch them up and update their understanding. And the fact that Fin also has access to past conversations, they are able to find similar conversations and workarounds that weren't documented anywhere else, which is a really great resource. In addition, when something technical comes up and that was outside their area, they were immediately able to tap Fin on the shoulder first, instead of having to escalate it or involve a technical teammate immediately. And that's part of the reason why we wanted a tiger team of experienced agents. We wanted them to really, really test out Fin AI Copilot and not just on the basic things. And this also served a secondary purpose of kind of turning these experienced agents into advocates for Fin AI Copilot. Less experienced agents, of course, or new agents, do stand to get the most out of Fin. But instead of hearing it from me, here's how it helped the team at Lightspeed.
In terms of how Fin AI Copilot is helping us onboard new agents, the biggest change we're seeing is in the outline of the curriculum that we typically undertake for a new team member. Usually, depending on the Lightspeed product that someone is joining, there's around 4 weeks of training. You know, a lot of that being classroom driven, you know, course driven, et cetera. And then towards the end, we typically engage in a degree of shadowing and kind of a soft go live. And that's the segment of the onboarding experience we're seeing a material impact on. Our newest team members that are starting to graduate their training, they're able to leverage this tool, and we're seeing them as our highest users of Fin AI Copilot. And we're just seeing them being able to ask complex questions or even getting just simple help that would have otherwise taken a little bit longer to get through either a shadowing or buddy experience or a real person, potentially through something like Slack. And they're getting that in more real time, and they're able to serve customers with more confidence.
So there are huge gains to be made, particularly for new agents joining. I do want to highlight one thing that Angelo mentioned there. Lightspeed agents were getting access to Fin only after they complete their initial training. And that's the way that we do it at Intercom too. Agents still need that base level of knowledge before they get access to a tool like this. Otherwise, they could just parrot an answer without really knowing what it meant, and that could result in a negative customer experience. Okay, so those are the main three steps, and the last one that we mentioned was optimizing your content. Here is Emil again on the importance of ensuring your content is up to date.
One of the things to keep in mind, though, whenever implementing an AI solution is to make sure that the resources that are used to feed it with relevant information are up to date, that they're not outdated, that there's not too much redundancy, and also that the information shared there is as concise as possible and as cohesive as possible. So by doing this first, it's a small upfront investment that helps you to drive a lot of positive results in the future.
So you can choose to optimize your content at any time. Obviously, the sooner the better, but you could actually wait, use Copilot for a while, and this can actually help you identify the places where your content needs improvement and more. Here's Angelo again.
The advice I would give to other customer service leaders that are thinking about adopting Fin AI Copilot is to consider not only the improvement to customer experience, but also what it will actually unearth within the rest of your operation. It has the ability to influence your employee onboarding experience. It has the ability to influence your content strategy. It has the ability to actually accelerate things like QA, where you're finding conversations that maybe didn't go the way that you had hoped, that didn't get detected through your traditional quality platforms. So I would say it's worth it, not only for the intention of Copilot, but for the auxiliary benefits that you may actually pull out of the learnings.
There is one other thing about the content sources that you use that I want to flag in this lesson. Using conversations as a source can be super powerful. You saw earlier how our tenured agents got a lot of use from Fin because it was pulling unique context and workarounds from past conversations that they could then apply to similar issues. When setting up conversations as a source, you may want to choose for Fin to only ingest conversations from your best or most experienced reps. Ensure that it pulls the best context in. And that's pretty much everything you need to know about how to roll out Fin AI Copilot to your team. Big thanks to Angelo and Emil for bringing this lesson to life.